Using Simscape Electrical, it is easy to model any electrical drive. In this case, we have an induction motor example, but the same idea applies to other motor types, such as permanent magnet synchronous motor. So in this particular demo, we start by adding the asynchronous machine square cage block and the converter block. Those two are the main two blocks on the machine side. On the grid side, we need a three-phase voltage source. We need a transformer, which in this case is a YY transformer. And we need a converter that will operate as a rectifier to provide the DC link voltage. In the diagram, light blue means composite three-phase connections, while dark blue, like here, means single-phase electrical connection. There is an option to select composite or expanded three-phase ports for any three-phase block in Simscape Electrical library by doing something like this. So right-click, and then we can select expanded three-phase ports. Also, it is quite easy to change the parameters for any block. We can add new features like add magnetic saturation for the induction motor. We can have a single squirrel cage or double squirrel cage. We can change the switching devices in the converter block. And we can change the parameters of the transformer depending on our application and depending on the requirements that we have for our system. Then we have the gate driver, which is implemented using a 6-pulse gate multiplexer. And this is the interface between Simulink controller and Simscape plant. As in any physical system, we need also some sensors to measure the relevant signals, such as currents and voltages. So we have a bunch of sensors here measuring the phase currents and voltages and measuring the DC link voltage. And also, we need to model the mechanical part and the mechanical load. So here we have a simple model with a machine inertia block and a torque source, which will allow us to adjust the load torque in the system. Not least important, in each physical network, we need to have one solver configuration block. And in this solver configuration block, we define the solver parameters which are used in the simulation. We can use a local solver in order to speed up the simulation and to prepare our model for hardened-loop simulation. And in the local solver, we can choose backward Euler. This will give us accurate results, but sometimes it's not as fast as we want. So as a trade-off, we shall consider the partitioning solver, which is faster but can be used in any model. And it is also quite easy to add new blocks in the model. For example, if I want to add here a permanent magnet synchronous motor block, I can just type the name and add this block into the model. Now that we have a plant model, we have to design the controller. And this is done in Simulink using field-oriented control based on PI controllers, which are still the main choice in industrial applications because every engineer knows how a PI controller works. We can use blocks from Simulink library and blocks from control sublibrary that we have in Simscape Electrical. Those control blocks from Simscape Electrical are designed for electrical systems in order to simplify the control design process for electrical systems. For example, in this case, we have the inverse park transform and the PWM generation using custom blocks from control sublibrary of Simscape Electrical. For the control algorithm, we have two PI controllers in the inner loop. One PI controller for the D-axis current and one PI controller for the Q-axis current. The D-axis current reference, which is the flux component, is obtained from a PI controller that regulates the magnetizing current. The Q-axis current reference, which is the torque component, is obtained from a velocity controller. And remember that this is a sensorless architecture, so we must estimate the velocity and rotor angle along with the magnetizing current. And this is done by employing a model reference adaptive control based flux observer, where the reference model is implemented using the stator equations to compute the D and Q components of the flux. Then we have the adaptive model implemented based on the rotor equations, and we have a PI controller that is used for the adaptation law. The grid side converter control is not covered in this presentation, but is quite similar to the machine side converter control. Now that we have modeled the system, next step is to start tuning the controller.